Hey folks, I'm Nate. I'm a technical marketing manager at Red Hat. I work with Red Hat Enterprise Linux, and I'm here to talk to you about... Hold on, let me get logged in. Alright, that's better. Oh wait, you want to know how I just did that? I guess we can talk about that.
So what is that? What did I just do? I logged into a RHEL machine using a account that's managed by Red Hat Identity Manager, Red Hat IDM, using a passkey, a YubiKey in this case, although any FIDO2 compliant key should work. Notice I didn't use a password. All I used was a PIN to unlock the YubiKey with. So this means that my account is that much more secure because I now have a physical token that grants me access to my machine. Now, this is a brand new feature, so there's still some rough edges, but this is coming with RHEL 9.4. So how does this make me more secure? It makes me more secure because a key is a lot harder to steal than a password. A password, we've seen time and time again, all it really takes is a convincing enough phish. It's happened to me. I've been tricked by websites. So have you, I'm sure. Or you know someone that has. It's really common. So first I'm going to walk you through how I added a IDM user that supports passkey. And that's going to be a combination of both the IDM user interface and some command line. Though there are ways to do all of these things, both from the command line or the UI. I do kind of a mixture of both because I think they work well. So we're going to show you that route. And then I'm going to show you the login and how you register a key and things like that. All right, so here we are at the IDM screen. I've already logged in. This is, if you go to your IDM deployment, go to the web admin console, you find a login or a page very similar to what you're seeing here on the screen. You see I've got a couple users here already. I'm gonna show you the Bob user that I did my login at the beginning of this video with. Obviously my name is not Bob, but whatever, it's a demo. So here we go. You can see Bob is here. Bob doesn't even have a password set, right? I did not create a password for Bob when I created this account, and I'm going to show you how to create a user in a minute. But you can see here that passkey has this public key mapping for the YubiKey that I used to log in. Now, if you can get the public key mapping, the public key from your YubiKey, without using the command line tool that I'm going to show you in a minute, then you can just throw that in here. You can click on this add button here, and you can add a key based on its public key. Now, you can get that out of the YubiKey. I'm just not going to show you that in this particular demo. So you could theoretically do the entire user creation right through the web UI. Now, obviously, there's other ways to log in here. We're going to ignore those for now. But here, user authentication types. You can see we have a number of different ways you could log in with this user. And I only have passkey checked. Now, you could set up more than one here. But for the sake of simplicity and the sake of this demo, we're going to use just passkey because I want my users to be as secure as possible. I don't want any chance they're going to accidentally give away their password or something. Okay, so that's the user that already exists. Now I'm going to show you how to make one, right? So it's really easy, honestly, within this web UI. And again, you can do this on the command line using the IPA user add command. And then there's another command to enable the passkey. But I'm going to show you those at the console once I've already created the user. So here we go. We're going to click the add button up here. This is dirt simple, right? We're going to put in a login name. We're going to go with a real creative login of user 02 because I've already got user 01. And we're going to make that user's first name user and their last name 02 because we got to be accurate, right? We're not going to touch private group, GUID, class, all those things. We're not going to give it a password. I'm going to click the add button. Now, at this point, if you wanted to, you could give this user access privileges through things like sudo by giving them access using, let's see, it's policy up here at the top. You can see I've got sudo rules set up already, right? And I've also got some user groups set up. So what we are going to do, I think, is you'll see I've got a sudo users group. We're going to add user 02. To the sudo users group, just as an additional demo here. Let's see, user groups, we're gonna add, we're gonna say sudo users, and this is a really simplistic sudo rule. It basically gives him all access via sudo. you can get more fine-grained than that. It works very similar to pseudo rules as you'd expect. But again, not the point of this demo. Okay, so we've given him an account. We've given him a group. He should already have access to our systems because we have a policy in place that says that all systems are accessible to all users. Again, that's a thing that you can limit with IDM. Not the point of this demo. Okay, so now that we have that, I'm going to take you over to my laptop over here where I have an actual system that is registered to my identity domain. I have to log in as an admin and bind a key.
All right, so we're going to attach a key to a user now. So I'm logged in to a RHEL workstation here. It's actually a VM on my laptop, but I've got my YubiKey already attached right here, right? I can't pull that out because it'll break things because of the VM pass-through. So I'm already at a shell. Let me make it a little bigger for you so you can see better. Now, so I'm already at a shell. Ignore the environment, right? This is a IDM user that I've logged in with a password. Now, so this might be, you know, an admin user, but really this, I logged in with a standard user, but I need to knit, that is, initiate a Kerberos session as an IDM admin, right? So for that, I'm just going to do knit admin, and it's going to assume what realm I'm authenticating to and ask me for the password. Okay, now if I did a klist, it shows me I have a Kerberos session open. All right, so what we're going to do now is we're going to modify the user that we just created, user 02. Okay, so we just issue some IPA user modification commands. First of all, we need to tell IDM that this user is going to use a passkey. So it's IPA user mod, and then user 02 was the name of the user that we added. And we need to add user auth type equals passkey. Now, if you remember, this is that series of checkboxes that we saw in the user that I showed you earlier. So this will tell it. This is basically, if we were to check the box that says use a passkey, this is what that's doing. Okay, and then it's going to do a thing, and there you go. It's going to show us what user it modified, its UID, GID, things like that. Now we have to actually register the passkey to the user. So let's go IPA user dash add dash passkey, and then we do user 02 and then dash dash register. Okay, and what this will do is it basically tells IDM we're going to add a passkey to the user, user 02, and we're going to register a new one. Okay, now right at this point, the IPA user command is querying my laptop to say, do you have a YubiKey connected? Oh, you do. What's the PIN for the YubiKey? I'm going to put in my PIN, then I'm going to hit enter. And then it just asks me to touch the device. And if you can see that, it's blinking. That's how you know when to hit the thing. So here we go. Bink. And there you go. It's going to map in this YubiKey for user 02 with this identifier. All right. And that should be it. If I log out here, yep, log out, and then we're going to log in with a new user that's not listed, and it's user 02 at idm0.lab. You can see in the password box here, it says insert your passkey device. Now, obviously there's more to that you can't read, but it's basically saying then press enter. We press enter, and now it says enter your PIN. So we're going to put in the PIN. Enter, and then it doesn't ask us anything, it just starts flashing. You hit the button, and we should get a desktop session. Now, you might remember, so brand new user, so it's asking me to take the tour, no thanks. You might remember we gave that user sudo rights. So if I do a sudo ls-l slash, pretty simple test, or how about let's just do sudo-l, which will tell it to list the sudo rights that we have. Insert your passkey device and then press enter. Huh, didn't even ask me for a password. That's kind of cool. Enter your PIN. And then it starts to flash. We hit the button and there it goes. It tells us all the things that we can do, which is all. You can see I can do whatever I want here. Now this should respect the same sudo mechanisms that you would expect. It all goes through SSSD, which, if you're not familiar with SSSD, that's a backend for the authentication mechanisms in PAM that tell it to talk to IDM, which is telling it to use the passkey. So anything that successfully uses SSSD should be able to use this passkey to do things, right? So let's do sudo, I don't know, vim etc password. There we go. Notice it didn't ask me again. That's because sudo's internal mechanisms have already recognized that I have sudo rights, and it's cached that, right? So it didn't need to ask me again. If I wait long enough for whatever the sudo timeout is on this machine, it'll ask me for the passkey again. So good to go. Okay. One more thing we could try. What about SSH from one machine to another? Well, guess what? That'll also use the passkey. So let's clear the screen first. I'm just going to SSH to the directory server for this particular identity domain as the user I just created. User02 at, what is it, dir0.idm0.lab. And it got me right in because I've already got a credential with Kerberos. So it passed the Kerberos token over to the SSH session. Now, I don't have a home directory there, so it just put me in slash. That's sort of one of the downsides of remote users. You can fix that. Again, not for this video.
So what do you think? Is that not the coolest thing since sliced bread? Am I dating myself with that weird reference? I think I am. It's the bee's knees. What's up? Anyway. So you might be saying an identity domain sounds like a lot of work to set up and configure. Well, there's good news for that too. There is an Ansible role that's included with RHEL that makes setup for IDM really simple. And I'll include a link in the description of this video for links to the RHEL docs on how you use that Ansible role. I use it to set up this lab. I can deploy an IDM lab, obviously a very simple configuration with a single IDM server and a single client, within a matter of like half an hour, because, you know, I've done it a few times and the Ansible role really makes it that simple. But you can get really complicated with this role too. You can set up replicas, you can register all your clients, you can even set up Active Directory trusts with the dang thing. That's pretty cool. So if you want to know more about Identity Manager, if you want to know more about RHEL and passkey, you're going to want to check out the RHEL documentation on the subject. I'll include links to those in the description of the video as well. Now, you might also think, well, Identity Manager sounds like it's probably expensive. Well, guess what? I've got good news there, too. It's included with your RHEL subscription. If you've got RHEL, you've got Identity Manager. And Identity Manager is great for more than just registering passkeys to users. It's great for centralized identity for Linux in general, right? So whether you're running RHEL or Fedora or some other Linux distribution, you can register it through the Identity Manager system and centrally manage your users, which is great. You can imply policy, you can imply password policy, you can imply, as I showed you, you can apply sudo rules and host access, right? You can limit who has access to what hosts. It's a really nice tool. You should really look into it. If you've already got a RHEL sub, you've already got it. I ran this thing in production for the deployment at my old employer, and it's actually really slick. It makes user management so much easier. Why set up accounts on 1,000 servers when you can set them up centrally, and then when someone leaves or changes roles, you can just change it in the identity domain? It's just so much nicer. All right, so thank you for watching the video. If you liked it, please make sure to like, subscribe to the channel. If you want to see more content like this, check out our live streams. You can find me on Into the Terminal every Friday, and you can find my counterpart Eric doing RHEL Presents every other week on Wednesdays, where he talks about new features coming to RHEL, interviews with engineers, and all kinds of great stuff. A little more hands-on stuff is Into the Terminal, so check that out as well. And again, thanks for watching. We'll catch you next time.